So, as you know that we had already started with the design of roof truss, and in the design of roof truss we had seen the different parameters of the truss, which are the different parameters of the truss. As you know that these are the different parameters of the truss, like ridge, purlin, GIO or AC sheets, strut, that is known as again the vertical member, principal rafter, tie member, incline member, and the column or wall. So these are the different parameters of the truss. And also we had seen the different types of the roof truss, that is the flat truss, half truss, as well as the pink roof truss and the Belgian truss. So these are the different types of truss that we had seen in the previous lecture. Now we had started with the design of the roof truss, and in the design of the roof truss we had done the loading calculations. So before that, just we will quickly revise the things that we had already seen in the previous lecture. So here is nothing but the geometry of the roof truss. So the pitch of the roof truss. So what do you mean by the pitch of the roof truss? Yes, the pitch of the truss is nothing but the minimum pitch that is to be maintained for the GI sheets covering is of 1/6, and for AC sheets, the pitch of the truss will be 1/12. Again, the spacing between the truss should be kept 1/3 to 1/5, the span of the truss, and the span by 4, that is up to the 20-meter span, and the span by 5 from 20 to 30-meter span. So this is the spacing of the truss. Purlins, everyone knows what do you mean by the purlins. Yes, generally the purlins varies from 1.35 to 2 meter, and the angle sections that are used for the smaller values of trusses are 3 to 4 meter for the medium sizes, and for 4 to 5 meter for the channel section or the eye section. Then also we are seeing the central rise, sheeting. In the sheeting, we have seen the different types of the sheeting, that is the GI sheets, AC sheets. This already we had covered in the previous lecture. Then the loading calculations. So the different loads are there that are acting upon the truss. So which are the different types of the loads? The different types of the loads are dead load, live load, earthquake load, and the wind load. So already we are seeing the detail, what is the dead load, live load, earthquake load, and the wind load. Yes, can anyone let me know which is the IS code that we are going to use for the earthquake load? That is for the seismic design. Seismic design ke liye hum kaun sa IS code refer karte hain? Yes, anyone from you? Which is the IS code that we use for the seismic design? Yes, Josh, Kanishka, for earthquake design, which is the IS code that we use to refer? The question is very simple, and already many times I have told you which is the IS code that you have to refer for the different things. So which one is the IS code that you refer for the earthquake design, that is for the seismic design? Hope am I audible to everyone? Yes, Josh, did you know the answer? Josh, Mohammed, Sabir, anyone from you? Either you can unmute yourself or you can mention in the chat box. Yes, Alwas. I hope am I audible to everyone. Yes. At least tell yes or no. Did you know the answer or not? Yes, Alwas, Kanishka. ओके 1893-2002, यस एग्जैक्टली करेक्ट. सो दिस इज द आईएसओ दैट वी यूज टू रेफर फॉर द सिस्मिक डिजाइन. व्हेनेवर वी हैव टू डू द सिस्मिक डिजाइन वी आर गोइंग टू यूज 1893-2002. Then comes up the problem. Already we had started with the design of the roof truss, and in that design we had seen that they have told us to define the principal rafter, main tie, and the intermediate members of the truss that are shown in the figure. For that they had given us some data. In that they had given us the cross section spacing of the truss. Again, they had given us the roofing material, that is the GI sheets, that is of 140 Newton per mm square, and they had given us the dead load. They had told us to consider the dead load due to roofing, purling, bracing, and the self weight of the truss, as well as they have given us the live load as per IS 875, and the wind load is also given to you, that is 1100 Newton per meter square. So this is the diagram that is being given to you. Already we had done with the dead load, live load, and the wind calculations. So everyone is having all those calculations. Should I start with the further design? Yes, in this we are seeing the geometry of the truss. After that we are seeing the inclination part, then the panel area in the plan. Okay, what about others? All the others are having the dead load, live load, and the wind load calculations. Any doubts in the dead load, live load, and wind load calculations so that I can start with the designing part of each and every part of the roof truss? Yes, Alwas, Sheikh Mohammed, Sabir, everyone is having all the loading calculations. Okay. डेड लोड, लाइव लोड और विंड लोड हमने पहली कैलकुलेशन कर लिया था. सी, दिस इज द टेबल for the dead load, live load, and the wind load calculations that we had seen. These are here the name of all the members that we had seen. Name of all the members. Then here there is the dead load that we had calculated for the all the members of the roof truss. Then comes up the live load. Again, the live load calculations we had done for all the members of the truss. Then here there is a wind load, and then comes up to be the loading combinations. So here there are the loading combinations, that is 1.5 dead load plus live load. Here 1.5 dead load plus wind load, and here 1.2 dead load plus live load plus wind load. So here, as you can see, everyone is having this table, and I hope everyone is having. And those who are not having, they can just note down the table. These are all the calculations that we have done the previously, and we had seen how to do these calculations by using the method of joints. Yes, if anyone is having any of the queries in these or up till here, you can ask. Otherwise, I can proceed further design. Just let me know. I hope everyone had done up till here. If you had completed up till here, reply yes in the chat box so that I can understand what to do. Yes, what about other? Done up till here. Okay. So we'll start with the designing part. First of all, we are going to design for the principal rafter. So जब हम principal rafter के लिए design करेंगे, tension, the force in the tension is 71.46 kN, and for the compression it is 70.68 kN. So whenever we are going to design for the principal rafter or any of the member of the roof truss, first of all, the very basic step is to just note down the values for the tension and compression. So tension हमें principal rafter का मिला है 71.46 kN, and compression we have got that is 70.68 kN. Now we'll proceed for the design for the compression. First of all, we are going to design for the compression. So compression के लिए जब design करोगे, तो सबसे पहला स्टेप है PD will be equals to A into FCD. This formula we will get from the clause number 7.12 from IS 800/2007. So इस पे से PD, fact PD is nothing but the factor load. So PD आपका कितना आया है? As you are going to design for the compression, compression के लिए design कर रहे हो इसलिए आपको क्या करना है? Compression का load consider करना है. तो compression का load हमें कितना मिला है? 70.68. So 70.68 into 10 raised to power 3 equals to A into FCD. FCD is nothing but the direct tensile stress that you need to assume the value for the FCD. So whenever the PD should be less than 125, agar PD aapka less than 125 ra, to FCD aapka rahega 90 megapascal. So yahan pe PD ki value hai aapki 70.68. So it is less than the value that is recommended by the IS code. So यहाँ पे आप FCD की value ले सकते हो 90 megapascal. So उसमें से आपको effective area मिलेगा 785.33 mm square. So first of all complete up till here, then we'll proceed further. Yes, any doubts up in here? If anyone is having any of the doubts, you can ask. Okay. Okay, everyone are done. Should I proceed further? यहाँ तक क्या हो गया सबका? Okay. So उसके बाद में आपको ऐसा सेक्शन चूज करना है स्टील टेबल में से जिसका इफेक्टिव एरिया आपका आपका जो इफेक्टिव एरिया आया है उसके एरिया से ज्यादा होना चाहिए. सो रेफर यू नीड टू रेफर सॉरी यू नीड टू रेफर स्टील टेबल. सो आपका एरिया कितना आया है इफेक्टिव एरिया व्हेन यू हैड कैलकुलेटेड यू हैड गॉट द वैल्यू दैट इज 785.33 mm स्क्वायर. Now you will take that section from the IS code whose area will be greater than the effective area that you had calculated. So आपने जो section choose किया है that is your ISA 50/50/5 mm. This is again from the steel table. सो उसका ग्रॉस एरिया कितना है, 958 mm square। नाउ यू नीड टू डू ऑल द चेक। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू आर गोइंग टू चेक फॉर द वी टू थिकनेस रेशियो। सो यू आर गोइंग टू डू द चेक फॉर वी टू थिकनेस रेशियो, दैट इज फ्रॉम द पेज नंबर 18, टेबल नंबर 2, एंड यू आर गोइंग टू कंसिडर क्लास 3। Always when you are going to do the width to thickness ratio check, you need to consider class C or class 3. So, सबसे पहले B by T देखोगे. B by T, B is your 50 as you are considered, sorry, as you are considered 50 by 50 by 5. आपका B कितना है? 50 and T is your 5. So it should be less than 15.7 epsilon. As you know, the value of epsilon is 1. So it is less than that. So your design is safe for width to thickness ratio. So first of all, complete up till here. And after completing, let me know. And if any of the doubts up till here, you can ask. After doing this check, let me know. Yes, done. हो गया यहाँ तक के सब काम। यस जस्ट अलवाज डन अप टिल हियर। Then D by T. Again, D is your 50 and T is your 5. So again, the value will be same. That is 10. Should be less than or equals to 15.7 epsilon. So epsilon, again, the value of epsilon is 1. So 15.8 is again safe. Then C is B plus D. This all comes under width to thickness ratio. And third, you have to check, that is B plus D by T should be less than 25 epsilon. So B is your 50, D is your 15. So 50 plus 50, that is 100, divided by T, that is 5. It is less than 25 epsilon. So again, your design is safe. So AG will be equal to A. मतलब जो आपका effective gross area है और जो sorry effective area and your gross sectional area will be same. That is AG will be equal to A. That will be 958. mm square. Now, उसके बाद में next step is to calculate the slenderness ratio lambda. So slenderness ratio lambda कैसे calculate करोगे? You need to refer the clause number 3.8 of your same IS code, that is IS 800-2007. उसमें से KL by R minimum, so K is 0.85, L is effective, that is given in the question, that is welded length, that is 2150 mm. Upon R minimum. R minimum is 15.2. So the value comes up to be 120.823. It is less than the value that you are given from the ISO 800-2007. So it is less than 180. So your design is safe for slenderness ratio. So complete update here for principal after. Yes, after completing, let me know. Yes, definitely, yeah. रेशो की वैल्यू मिली सबको. Yes, done. Okay. So after calculating the slenderness ratio, sorry, you need to find FCD. So FCD calculate करने के लिए again you need to refer table number 9C, page number 42. So in table number 9C, page number 42, and for FY, by default you have to consider 250 only. So आपका lambda कितना आया है? Lambda की value आपको मिली है 120.23. So 120.23 lambda के लिए आप FCD calculate करो. So FCD calculate करने के लिए again you need to refer the I score. So उसमें से आपको 120 के लिए FCD की value मिलती है 83.7. And for 130, you are going to get the value for FCD as 74.3. So, dono mein se interpolation karke, you need to calculate the value for 120.23. So, uske liye aapko FCD ki value milti hai something 83.48 Newton per mm square. So, do opt it here, then we are going to calculate for the PD. Yes, so what up to here? Everyone has got the value for FCD. After getting the value of FCD, let me know so that we can proceed further. I hope all the others are also completed. Okay, I'm waiting, completed. Okay, we'll wait for 1 minute. Let her complete and then we'll proceed further. Okay, एफसीडी की वैल्यू मिलने के बाद में यू नीड टू डिजाइन फॉर द टेंशन. टेंशन अभी हमने क्या किया, वी आर डिजाइन फॉर द कॉम्प्रेशन. नाउ यू नीड टू डिजाइन फॉर द टेंशन. टेंशन के लिए डिजाइन करने के टाइम पे आपको क्या करना है, यू आर टू एज्यूम M12 एंड 4.6 ग्रेड ऑफ द बोल्ट एज वेल एज द थिकनेस टू एज्यूम इज 10 mm. तो एम आप क्या करोगे, M14 का बोल्ट लोगे एंड उसका ग्रेड लोगे 4.6 एंड इट शुड बी 10 mm थिक. Gusset plate is being provided over there and the standard clearance for M12 and M14 and the edge distance, and as you know already, as it's the connection sums. Connection sums mein aapko kya karna hai, sorry, usme aapne kya calculate kiya tha, edge distance calculate kiya tha. So edge distance, minimum edge distance and maximum edge distance. तो मिनिमम एज डिस्टेंस कितना है, 1.5 इनटू डायमीटर ऑफ द होल. अभी डायमीटर ऑफ द होल इज 13 एंड द मैक्सिमम एज डिस्टेंस इज 40 इनटू 43. दिस इज नथिंग बट द थिकनेस ऑफ द प्लेट. सो अभी 40 प्लस 40 सो 40 इनटू थिकनेस, थिकनेस है आपकी 10, सो 40 प्लस 4 इनटू टी दैट इज 80 mm. सो यू कैन प्रोवाइड ई एज 22 mm. So first of all, draw up till here, draw up till edge distance, then we'll proceed further. Yes, after getting the value of edge distance, let me know so that we can proceed further. Edge distance calculate karo and slightly increase your speed. Yes, over. ओके ओके, सो ये आपको मिला है 22 mm. आफ्टर गेटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ ई, व्हाट यू नीड टू डू, यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट द गेज डिस्टेंस. सो गेज डिस्टेंस आपको मिलता है 28 mm. यू नीड टू एज्यूम द वैल्यू ऑफ गेज डिस्टेंस एज 28 mm. Then you need to do the calculations for the end distance. So end distance calculate करने के लिए you are having the formula that is 1.5 into diameter of the hole that is D0. So 1.5 into D0 that is 1.5 into 13. So it is 19.5 mm. So end distance comes out to be 30 mm. So do up till here, then we'll proceed further. Calculate the values for the gauge distance and the end distance. Yes, done. Everyone had completed up till here. हो गया यहाँ तक के सबका, शुड आई प्रोसीड फर्दर? ओके, अभी आपने एज डिस्टेंस, गेज डिस्टेंस एंड एंड डिस्टेंस कैलकुलेट किया है. नाउ यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट द पीच डिस्टेंस. सो फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग द पीच डिस्टेंस कैलकुलेट करने के लिए सबसे पहले आपको क्या करना है, मिनिमम पीच कैलकुलेट करना है. सो मिनिमम पीच आप कैसे कैलकुलेट करोगे? फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग द मिनिमम पीच यू आर हैविंग द फॉर्मूला दैट इज 2.5 इंटू डायमीटर ऑफ द बोल्ट. सो 2.5 इंटू डायमीटर ऑफ द बोल्ट दैट इज 12. So minimum pitch comes up to be 30 mm, and the maximum pitch, the formula to calculate the maximum pitch is 32 T or 300 mm. So, and again 16 T or 200 mm, the three formulas are there to calculate the maximum pitch distance. So from three maximum value you have to consider. So maximum आपकी कितनी है 300 और minimum pitch की value है 30. तो ये दोनों के बीच की वैल्यू लेना है आपको. सो मिडल वन वैल्यू वी आर गोइंग टू कंसीडर. सो मिडल वी आर गोइंग टू कंसीडर द पीच एज 60 mm. सो पीच डिस्टेंस आपको मिलता है 60 mm. सो डू अप टिल हियर. ये सो पिच डिस्टेंस हो गया सबका. लास्ट 1 मिनट इज देयर, सो रिजॉइन द लेक्चर अगेन एट 9:50. I hope everyone had done up till the PhD distance.